Such treasure found. Thank you.
Well, good morning to you, and happy 4th of July. Are you excited to celebrate God's goodness to us as Americans today? Amen. Let's stand and do that. We want to celebrate and thank God for living in this beautiful land that we call America the Beautiful. Let's sing together. Debbie, give me just a little bit more on the track. Here we go now.
Oh, beautiful for spacious skies, for amber waves of grain, for purple mountain majesties above the fruited plain. America, America, God shed his grace on thee, and to crown thy good with brotherhood, shining sea. Oh, let's see that red, white, and blue this morning. Beautiful. Oh, beautiful for heroes proved in liberating strife, who more than self their country loved, and mercy more than life. Amen. God thy gold refine, till all success be nobleness and every gain divine.
Tell the person next to you, you're singing good, and sing it louder.
Oh, beautiful for patriot's reign that sees beyond the years, thine alabaster city's plate undimmed by human tears.
Let's hear it.
America, America, God shed his grace on thee and crown thy good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea. America, America, God shed his grace on thee and crown thy good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea.
God has been good to us, hasn't he? Amen. Hey, before you sit down, say hi to two or three people.
And after you get done with that, you may be seated. Well, good morning, church, and welcome to Capri Christian Church. My name is Wes, and I'm one of the pastors on staff. And it is my pleasure to welcome you this good July 4th morning. You know, I'm looking out, and a lot of you don't need flags. You just need to kind of dance because you are flags. So it is good to see you all this morning. And if you're new with us or visiting with us, we'd love to see you at the Welcome Center. Who's back there today? Jerry and Pam are back there today. Jerry and Pam would love to welcome you, and we have a gift if you are new with us, and if you fill out a connect card with us, we will connect with you through this next week by giving you a phone call. There will all be also sent some mail to you, all my junk mail that I don't want, I'm going to send to you. No, we're just going to send you a little postcard, just welcome you and send some love your way. And if you're online with us and want to connect with us, you can go to CapriChristianChurch.org/connect. And as we continue today, we just would love to share God's word with you and God's grace as well. So please join us in our next song.
Thank you, Wes. Appreciate that. Just by a show of hands real quick, how many veterans do we have in the room this morning? We got a few over here, right here. All right, let's give them a quick round of applause. Before we get into the rest of the song service and our presentation by the Capri Celebration Singers, veterans, you're going to play a special part in our service today. We've got a song called the Armed Force Medley, and it's a medley of all the different military branch songs. And so when we get to that song, you're going to be invited. For instance, when we start singing the song for the Army, you're going to come up if you're an Army veteran, and you'll just stand right here front and center. And you'll stay up here as the Navy, the Air Force, the Coast Guard, and the Marines, they will all join you. The rest of us will stand and applaud and sing your song for you. So just make note of that. But certainly we celebrate America. We are thankful for our veterans who fought to give us freedom. And we celebrate America as Christians in a different way, because we as Christians certainly understand freedom in a greater light because of what Christ has done. And so when we celebrate freedom, we also reflect on the freedom that Christ gave us on the cross. And so this morning we want to sing about that, and everything that we do to celebrate America, it is through the scope of God's blessing on us as a nation and enjoying freedom and the people that have stood on His word to protect our rights. Let's sing this beautiful song together called Jesus Keep Me Near the Cross.
Jesus, keep me near the cross. Bear a precious fountain, free to all a healing stream, flows from Calvary's mountain. In the cross, oh, in the cross, be my glory. Soul shall find rest beyond the river. And near the cross a trembling soul, love and mercy found me. Its beams around me. In the cross, in the cross, be my glory ever, till my raptured soul shall find rest beyond the river. Before me, help me walk from day to day with its shadows o'er me. In the cross, in the cross, will be my glory ever, till my raptured soul shall beyond the river. Near the cross I'll watch and wait, hoping, trusting ever, till I reach the golden strand just beyond the river. In the cross, in the cross, be my glory ever, till my raptured soul shall find rest beyond.
Take just a moment, if you would, to reflect on the cross this morning, the difference it's made in your life, and giving eternal life, eternal salvation through Jesus Christ. Take just a moment and thank Him.
gentlemen, please rise for our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly seen.
Land of the free and the home of the brave. These treasured words describe the land we love. Despite our flaws and challenges, we gather to celebrate America. For this is a land where hope still shines and freedom still reigns.
My country is of the sweet land of liberty. Of thee I sing, land where my fathers died, land of the pilgrims died, from every mountainside let freedom ring. Our fathers God to thee, author of liberty.
Yeah.
find lots of ways to celebrate Independence Day. We march in parades, wave the flag, get together with family and friends, eat too much, and enjoy watching fireworks in towns all across this great land. And we always set aside time to remember and to pray for the men and women who have sacrificed so much to keep us strong and free. They've left home and family, served in lonely, sometimes dangerous places, and endured hardship and suffering for the sake of liberty. Some have paid the ultimate price in defense of and in service to this nation. If you have served or are now serving in one of the branches of our military, please stand as we sing your song.
Trail as those caissons go rolling along. In and out, hear them shout, counter-arching all about as those caissons go rolling along. For it's high, high, he in the field artillery. All out, your numbers loud and strong.
2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3.
And wherever you go, you will always know that those caissons go rolling along. Rolling along.
Army, stay right where you are. Navy, join us.
Navy.
Anchors away, my boys. Anchors away. Farewell to college joys. We sail at break of day. Day, day, day. Shore, hail to the foe, until we meet once more. He's wishing you a happy voyage home. Anchors away.
Let's hear it for the Navy.
Air Force.
All right, Air Force, come on up.
Off we go into the wild blue. Into the sky. Here they come, zooming to meet our thunder. And a boy's given the gun. And we die, starting our plane from under. Off with one terrible roar. We live in vain, or we're down in vain. But nothing can stop the U.S. Air Force. Nothing can stop the U.S. Air Force. We're always ready for the call. We place our trust in thee. Through howling, chill, and shot and shell to win the victory. Semper Paratus is our guide, our pledge, our motto too. We're always ready.
All right, where's our Marines at this morning?
Marines!
Marines!
From the halls of Montezuma to the shores of Tripoli, we will fight our country's battles in the air, on land, and sea. First to fight for right and freedom, and to keep our honor clean. We are proud to claim the title of United States Marines. Marines.
Army, Navy, Air Force.
ovation, if you will. Thank you. Thank you for your service. And we'll let them be seated.
His grace to be on.
I could take you to a harbor with freedom's torch ablaze,
or a blue Pacific island where a tattered flag was raised.
And I could take you to a rolling grassy field where rose markers speak of sacrifice.
I could take you to where the towers fell,
to the echoes of a thousand masts, I love yous and goodbyes. And I'm sure that you'd be moved to tears by the weight of what you saw. You'd hear those acts of courage and could only stand in awe. And I know that you would think you'd see a picture of true love. But if you want to see it all, let me take you to the cross. Take you to a hillside, a scene you won't forget.
See a man who agonizes with the cost of every breath.
Come and touch the nails that pierce his feet and hands. Oh, and watch him as he fights to see it through. Enough to know it was for you. And I'm sure that you'd be moved to tears by the weight of what you saw. Oh, you'd view those acts of courage and could only stand in awe. You have seen true love. So if you want to see it all, let me take you to the cross. Oh, let me take you to the place that fills your emptiness inside. There's no other place where you can grow to find eternal life. And I'm sure that you'd be moved to tears by the weight of what you saw. Oh, you'd use the facts of courage and could only stand in awe. And I know that you would think you'd see a picture of true love. But if you want to see it all, let me take you to the cross. Oh, when mercy there was great, and grace was free. Take you. We'll let these guys be seated. Boy, that last song that we just sang, that was powerful words in there. Thinking about the sacrifice of men and women throughout our history that have fought to preserve our rights. But then taking it even further, taking it to the man, the Son of God, Son of Man, who died on a cross. And so if you want to see it all, let me take you to the cross. Because there's where mercy is. There's where grace, what changes your life and gives you complete freedom. Freedom from your sin. Christ came to break the chains so that you and I could be free and be free indeed. And that's what today has been about, celebrating. You see, as we celebrate America, it gives us another chance, another opportunity to completely understand freedom, to appreciate it even more. Because even the freedom that we have here as Americans is still a little bit limited, especially when you compare it to the absolute freedom that Christ has given. And so we are going to move into a time of our communion this morning, and we would invite all believers this morning to join us at the table. We'll have a prayer. If you're sitting in these seats right here, you'll simply come down to the front, and one of the ushers will have the cracker that represents Christ's broken body. So you'll take one of those, and then if you're sitting here, you'll go towards this table. Here you'll go to this table, and you'll pick up the cup of juice that reminds us of Christ's blood. If you're sitting on the exits over here, go towards the wall and then come to the table that way and return to your seat as well. But let's reflect about Christ and how he died on that cross, how he took your sins, he took my sins, all the sins of the world, and he said, even though they're not mine, Father, let me take them. I'll take your wrath so they don't have to. That's what Jesus did. And if you don't know that, if you haven't accepted Jesus as Lord and Savior, then friend, you don't really know what freedom is. Such a simple thing to say yes to Jesus and to praise him for eternity for what he's done. Let's have a word of prayer, and then we'll stand and invite you to the table to remember the broken body and the blood that was poured out for freedom. Heavenly Father, thank you today that we celebrate our independence here as Americans. But every Lord's Day, we're reminded as we come to your table that as Christians, we celebrate freedom every day. And this is a great reminder for us on the Lord's Day to be at your table, to remember what it cost you to give your one and only Son, that whoever would place their trust in him and accept him as Lord and Savior would not have to worry about facing your wrath and could spend eternity in heaven with you and avoid hell. So we pray that as we've reflected on that, we'll come to the table with the right heart, a right attitude. We'll submit to your way. And having these emblems today reminds us that we need to be living for you every day because people are looking to us as examples. May we live a life that says to them, we are free indeed because what Jesus has done for us. In that name of Jesus, we do pray these things. Amen. Let's stand up and come to the table.
Whatever we face as a nation, whatever we face personally, as believers and followers of Jesus, we know that ultimately our only answer in this life is in Psalm 46, 1. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear.
You crush the enemy underneath my feet. You are my sword and shield. No troubles linger still. Whom shall I fear? I know who goes before me. I know who stands behind. The God of angel armies is always by my side. The one who reigns forever, he is a friend of mine. The God of angel armies is always by my side. I know who goes before me. I know who stands behind. The God of angel armies is always by my side. The one who reigns forever, he is a friend of mine. The God of angel armies is always by my side. And nothing formed against me shall stand. You hold the whole world. Your promises, you are faithful, and nothing formed against me shall stand. You hold the whole world in your hand. I'm holding on to your promises, you are faithful. You are faithful. Now in God we trust, in His name we hope. I know I will not be shaken. God is here with us, He's already won. I know shaken. Now in God we trust, in His name we hope. I know God will not be shaken. God is here with us, He's already won. I know God will not be shaken. I know God will not be shaken. I know God will not be shaken. I know who goes before me. I know who stands behind. The God of angel armies is always by my side. The one who reigns forever, He is a friend of mine. The God of angel armies is always by my side. The God of angel armies is always by my side. The God of angel armies is always by my side.
No, it's not time for my solo. Thank you. I was going to compliment the choir, but now I'm not going to. No. No, thank you, Steve and choir, for the presentation. Excellent. Thank you. Thank you. Look forward to this every year because I'm a flag waver. I'm a flag waver. You see the signs around the church. I support our troops. We support our police. We're all in. And we're glad to have this every year. And I really, really, I talk to people and they say, they go to the service, they say, I've never seen one like this before. And I said, you may not see them ever again in other churches because nobody's doing this. But we are. And we're going to keep doing it. And we're so thankful you came this morning. A lot of our people are visitors with us for the first time. Please stop by the welcome booth on the way out. Don't forget that we have a picnic that we worked on the last couple of days for you after the second service. It's at 12:15, and we've got enough food for the Marines and the Army, okay? So come on out and be part of that. Stay for that part of the service. Also, there's a book here that we want you to have. It says the First American Bible. This is the First American Bible, the Antioch Bible, that was printed because during the Revolutionary War, there was blockades up and they couldn't get Bibles in the country. So the Congress had them print their own. And this organization is trying to get these Bibles in every school because they're a historical document. And we'd love to see that happen. Take the book. It is yours. We want you to have it. Can they keep the flag, Steve? Okay, you can keep the flags, unless there's blood on the end of this. You want to keep it. We're so glad to have you with us today. We hope we see you at the picnic. Let's stand together and let's pray. Lord, we are so grateful to be here, and I'm thankful for these voices and the practice and the work they put into these fine people as they share this patriotic message and song with us. We need to hear this. Need to hear this all the time, and we thank you, Lord. We're able to get together in this service to wave flags, to pay honor to our country and the flag, but also to you. And we thank you again for letting us gather around this table, letting us give gifts, letting us pray. Bless us later on as we eat together. We thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you. Have a great day.
Father has poured out on us that we should be called the children of God. How great is the love the Father has poured out on us that we should be called the children. Sent his only son that we could become the children of God. We will never perish if we believe in him, and we can become the children of God.